So hello, this is Khurram Nasir and you're watching Optometry with Khurram, and today's topic is about the retinal image sizes. Once I was teaching in my university class, and I teach my students that hyperopic patient will always observe smaller images than the normal, and myopic patient will always observe bigger images than the normal. And one of the student raised his hand and said, "Sir, what are you talking about? We prescribe plus lenses in hypermetropia and you teach us that plus lenses always magnify the size of the image, right? And you teach us that a myopic patient in myopia, we always prescribe minus lenses, and minus lenses always minify the size of the images." Somehow he was right, but this is a misconception I need to clear. Remember that hyperopia means that least plus power inside the eyeball, right? And myopia means there is greater plus power than the normal, right? And now we are going to learn that, we are going to prove that always in a hyperopic patient, he or she, a hyperopic one, will always observe smaller images, and myopic patient will always observe the bigger images. And we will clarify, clarify this concept with two different examples, right? You know very well that there are different types of ametropia. Like we have axial ametropia and we have refractive ametropia. So we are going to clear this misconception with these two terminologies. So first of all, we will clear this misconception with the help of the refractive ametropia. You know what ametropia mean, the refractive errors. It could be myopia or it could be hypermetropia or it could be astigmatism, right? We will discuss only hypermetropia and myopia in this lecture, right? So first of all, we will learn about the definition, the actual clinical definition of myopia. The myopia means that we have, first of all, let's discuss about the normal eye, the ametropic eye, right? The normal one. You know very well that the total power of the eyeball in a normal eyeball, in ametropic eyeball, is 58 approximately, right? Different books, I always mention that different books, different authors write different dioptric value of the eyeball, right? So I'm considering 58 diopter is the normal power of the eyeball, and the cornea is contributing 43 diopters and lens is contributing 15 diopters, right? And this is the normal parameter of the refractive power of the eyeball or dioptric power of the eyeball, the 58 diopters, right? And if we see in hypermetropia, hypermetropia means that there is always deficiency of the plus power, right? If we talk about the refractive hypermetropia, then it means that the power of the refractive power of the eyeball is reduced, is decreased than the normal. So that eye will be a hyperopic eye, right? Or refractive hypermetropia, it is called refractive hypermetropia. And if you talk about the myopia, you know very well that in myopia, the total power of the eyeball is greater than the normal, right? Increased plus power, right? So that eye with increased plus power is called myopia, right? And we prescribe minus lenses to reduce myopia or to treat or to manage myopia, right? So this is called the refractive myopia. And you know very well that plus power, there is always a concept of plus power inside the eyeball. Cornea got plus power and lens got plus power as well, but somehow cornea has minus power as well, because there are two surfaces of the cornea, the front surface and the back surface, right? But the total first front surface is convex and the back surface is concave, so there is a little bit concept of minus power as well in the cornea. But collectively, in a broader spectrum, we say that the eyeball got plus power only, right? Suppose if the eyeball is increasing its power, so that increasing power is plus, and if eyeball is decreasing its power, so that decreasing power is plus, right? So there is a concept of plus power, increasing or decreasing, there is a concept of plus power inside the eyeball, right? So you know very well that what is the properties of, what are the characteristics of the plus power of the plus lenses. You know, cornea is plus lens, and lens, the crystalline lens actually itself is a plus lens. So you know very well the characteristics of the plus lenses. You know, the plus lens will always magnify, right? Will always magnify the image, right? And minus lens will always minify the images. This is the major concept, this is the basic concept you need to learn, right? So we already know that the plus lenses will magnify the lenses. And you know very well, if we clarify this misconception that in myopia, right? The myopic patient will always see bigger images than the normal. Why? Because in myopia, the plus power is increased, right? Myopia is the name of increase in the plus power, right? When plus power will be increased, that is called myopia. So plus power is increased in, suppose plus power is increasing in my eyeball, so I am myopic. This is refractive myopia, because dioptric power of the eyeball is increasing than the normal, right? So if plus power is increasing than the normal, it means that there will be a magnifying concept, there will be a magnifying image than the normal, right? The image will be bigger than the normal one. Why? Because in myopia, what I said, myopic patient will always observe the bigger images than the normal. Why? Because the refractive power is greater. And which power is increasing? Plus power is increasing. And when plus power will be increased, that can cause a magnifying images. So that could be one of the reason, right? And if we move towards the hyperopia, you know very well, hyperopia actually is the refractive error in which the plus power of the eyeball will get decreased. So there is least plus power, there is deficiency of plus power in the eye, in terms of hyperopic eye, right? So there is deficiency of plus power, and when plus power is decreased, right? So plus power is decreasing means that the image will be smaller, because the plus power, the property of the plus power is it will magnify the image, and when plus power is decreasing, it means that will cause a smaller images than the normal. So this is one of the reasons. And now we are moving towards the another you can say the reason that why myopia see bigger images and why hypermetropia see the smaller images than the normal one. So I'm going to draw eyeball. You see, this is the normal eyeball, right? And now we are going to discuss about the axial ametropia, right? We have experienced about the refractive ametropia. Now we are going to learn about the axial ametropia. And now this is the normal eyeball, right? And you know very well that in hypermetropia, the eyeball is smaller than the normal. So this red point, this red line is actually indicating the smaller eyeball. So this, in the black marker, this is ametropic eye, the normal one. This is smaller eye. You see, this is smaller eye, a hyperopic eye, right, in the red marker. And this in the blue marker is the myopic eye. You know very well that in ametropia, the size of the eyeball is normal, which is 24 millimeter as well. But if, so this black marker is indicating the normal eye, right? But if you talk about this red eyeball, this is the axial length of this eyeball is reduced. And if you talk about this blue eyeball, the axial length of the blue eyeball is maximum, is normal, is increased than the normal, right? So we can say that red eyeball is hyperopic, black eyeball is emetropic, normal, and the blue eyeball is myopic. So the axial length of the red hyperopic eye is smaller than the normal, right? And the axial length of the blue myopic eyeball is larger or bigger than the normal. And the eyeball which is in black is normal. The axial length is normal, right? So hyperopic eye got smaller eyeball, emetropic eye got normal size of the eyeball, normal axial length, and myopic eye got the larger eyeball, right? The axial length is larger than the normal. You see, this is smaller eye, this is hyperopic eye, right? And this is towards the black, this is the normal eye, and axial length is maximum in blue, that is myopic eye. And now we will learn about the concept of reduced eye. There are two system of the eyeball. One is schematic system and other one is the reduced system of the eyeball. We are going to discuss about the reduced eyeball system, and you know very well what is actually the nodal point. If we consider that at the center, exactly the nodal point is actually, if you see, this is the round cornea, and the center of this, center of curvature is this point, and this point is called the nodal point. In reduced eye, this center of curvature of this sphere refracting surface is called the nodal point. And you know very well that the nodal point is the point from where if light ray will pass through, then it will not bend to anywhere, it will go straight ahead, right? So this is the nodal point. And remember one thing, that in normal eye, from this black one, from here, the distance between the retina and this nodal point, this is 17.2 mm. Remember that this is the normal, right? The distance between the nodal point and the normal retina, which got the normal axial length, the distance between the nodal point and the retina of the normal eye is 17.2 millimeter. And now, whenever the light will pass through this eyeball, we have three different eyeballs. We have hypermetropic eye, we have emetropic eye, and we have myopic eye as well, right? So whenever a light will pass through . So this is the light is passing through the eyeball, and you see the line is crossing over here, right? And if we measure the size of the eyeball, so this is this red marker, the area which is between these two black lines, the area between this is an image which is substandard by the hyperopic eye, and the area between these two lines is the area which is made by the normal eye, the emetropic eye. And this area which is between these two black lines, this area is the image size of the myopic eye. So you can see very easily, as the axial length of the eyeball is increasing, the image size is increasing as well. It means that the axial length and the image size are directly proportional to each other. I'm writing it that axial length is directly proportional to the image size. Whenever the axial length will decrease, image size will decrease. Whenever image size will increase, axial length will increase, right? So you can see in hyperopic eye, the size of the image is so small. You see, this is small images, are lesser than the normal. And if we move, the axial length will increase in the normal eye, so the image size will increase as well, right? So the length between these two is smaller. When we will approach towards the normal, when axial length will increase, the size of the image will increase as well. You see the increase. And whenever we will move towards the greater axial length, the image size will increase than the normal one. So as we are increasing the axial length of the eyeball, the image size is gradually increasing because they are directly proportional to each other. So in hypermetropia, the image size is small because the axial length is small. In emetropia, the image size is bigger than the hyperopic one because the axial length is increased than the hyperopic eye. And in myopia, the image size is maximum because the axial length is maximum. So as the axial length will increases, the image size will also increase because they are directly proportional to each other. And now with a basic formula, with the easy formula, we can calculate the image size of emetropic eye, of a hyperopic eye, or myopic eye. For example, this is a normal eye. This is the nodal point, right? The center of curvature. And this is retina. And you know very well that the distance between the nodal point and the retina is 17.2 millimeter in normal eye, in emetropic eye. This is emetropic eye, right? And the formula is, we can simply, if you want to find the retinal image size in emetropic eye, we can simply multiply this 17.2 millimeter with an angle with A. And what is this angle about? Angle is about, if we put a object before the normal lens, so for example, this is the image, right? So whenever this object will passes through the nodal point, it will go straight ahead like this. It will not deviate, it will not bend anywhere. So you see, this is, there is an angle between here. This angle is called A. This A is representing that angle, the refracting angle, right? Or the angle of incidence. So whenever at the top of the object, if a light passes through the nodal point, it will go straight ahead like this. It will not bend towards anywhere. It will go straight ahead and then it will make a angle. That angle is called A, right? And that the value of the angle will be in radian. So for example, if the distance between the nodal point and the retina is 17.2 and angle is 0.1 radian, then what will be the image size in emetropic eye? That will be 1.72. And now we will learn about the hyperopic eye. So a hyperopic eye is smaller than the normal. So this is the nodal point, and you know very well the distance between the nodal point and the retina is in the normal eye, that was 17.2, right? But this eye is reduced, right? This eye is smaller than the normal because this is hyperopic eye. So that value will be, you can say 16.2. This is a supposed value, for example, and angle is 0.1 radian. Then the retinal image size in hyperopic eye will be, you can say 1.62 millimeter, right? And if we compare this with the myopic eye, which is a bigger eye, right? And this is the nodal point, right? And the distance between the nodal point and the retina will be more than ever, right? Because this is myopic eye. So it is, for example, 18.2 millimeter, 18.2, right? And we will put in the formula. So retinal image size in myopic eye will be 18.2 into 0.1 radian, and the answer will be 1.82 mm. So that will be image size of the retinal image size in myopic eye. I hope this is clear. We'll see you in the next videos.